Thank you, Madam Chair. We've been talking about workforce for such a long time. Senator Hickenlooper and I recently did a subcommittee hearing on it. I'm going to draw upon what was the biggest issue in my home state of Indiana pre-COVID was workforce. I'd hear workforce, 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 some rural broadband, depending on your county, and affordable housing. And now I'm going to go back to when I first started paying attention to it. It was when I was CEO of my own company, when it was really starting to grow in the last 10 years of the 37 years I was doing that, and looked into my own school districts in my county. And I think the issue with workforce, everything I've heard today is tangential. I think the biggest issue with workforce is that we've almost stigmatized some of those pathways. And I'll give you this little vignette to hear how shocked I was. Come from the lowest unemployment county in the highest manufacturing per capita county in the state of Indiana. We as employers, mine was a logistics and distribution business, all the other companies were manufacturing. And it was depressing to hear that in our own schools, of the 60 to 80,000 jobs that we had begging, they weren't for four-year degrees. Maybe a little bit of STEM, but generally a better life skills training in high school. I took industrial arts when I went to high school, and that's probably something I remember more about than almost any other class. But almost all of those were gone, and it was AP. The only way you can be successful in life is getting a four-year degree. Well, the market doesn't call for that. Parents have now had a recent graduate or two that has a degreed son or daughter back in the basement because it was an ill-advised degree with no market. Half the kids that get on that journey for a four-year degree don't complete it. State Board of Education and all of the educational institutions within states, I think, have oversold that. We ship twice as many degrees out of our state as we keep within four-year degrees. I'd love to see high school curriculum get back to the basics and start teaching some of these skills that we'd all love to see, to where we can even train you. Employers have been too dependent on the system too. Now they're getting with it. Like to hear Ms. Watts, Mr. Beard, what you think of what I've just said. How important is that to create incomes close to, it'd be almost $1 billion in Indiana if we just did a better job at what I'm talking about?
Thank you, Senator, for that question. And in Kentucky, your neighbor to the south, we too are a manufacturing and logistics hub, and so those careers are very important. And I think we've actually done quite a disservice the last several years when we would hear the rhetoric, college isn't for everyone. What we should have been saying is that something post-high school is for everyone, whether it's a degree, credential, certificate, two-year education, something after high school was for everyone. And so in Kentucky, we're actually even looking at using scholarship dollars for students to be able to go to those pathways that we will need in our logistics and our manufacturing sectors, because we know those are the jobs that we are needed right now. They're good-paying jobs. They can usually have a year or so training and get right into them. So we are completely aligned, but I do think it's going to be an alignment between the business community and the education community as well. And in Kentucky, our community and technical college system has really been at the forefront of making sure we have the students that are going to meet those needs of our employers in Kentucky.
Thank you. Mr. Beard.
Senator, I would say amen first. Second, the initiative I specifically lead focuses on those particular occupations. 30% of those roles that require education and skills beyond high school and less than 4 years of college are what we need in Houston. And like, you know, Kentucky, we have a significant manufacturing sector, a healthcare sector, an automotive sector, transportation. All of those jobs, you can leave high school with a good career and technical education program and find a pathway. And I think it requires two things. One, the employer leadership to communicate that back into the school system and partner differently with the school districts and the community colleges. And second, we need to change the awareness and perception and narrative that's going on. And we did some focus group research to understand kind of the perceptions and misperceptions that families and parents have related to that, all because of the four-year narrative. And so we have to do a different job. Thank you.
Thank you. And real briefly, in closing, not to mention that higher education, post-secondary education, has now eclipsed the increase in the cost of healthcare each year. And that'd be the number two issue in this country that's got to be addressed as well, where it's a fixed cost just with different curriculum to do the things in high school that I think cure a lot of the problems we contend with after high school. Thank you.
Thank you.